Hey guys, in this video I'm going to go over a statistical technique called the inverse transform method, and this is basically a method of generating non-uniform random variables with a desired distribution F. And it's a pretty simple technique that I'm going to go over in a minute, but basically what it lets you do is it lets you create random variables that are not uniformly distributed and that have some desired distribution that you want, and from there you can use this technique to randomly sample from that random variable that you generated. So I'm going to do an example in this video of generating a random variable that's exponentially distributed with this PDF, and I'm going to go over how you do that using the inverse transform method, and then I'm going to go to R and do a quick demo of how you can create random samples with this desired distribution, in this case, again, using the exponential distribution as an example. So let's go ahead and get started. I have the lemma for how the inverse transform method works written out here. And basically what it does is it takes u, a random variable that is uniformly distributed, and it takes a CDF of a distribution F that you desire your random variable to have. And using the inverse of the F distribution that you want, you just plug in u to the inverse CDF. And then if you sample from this distribution, it will have the desired distribution that you want. So if x is a new random variable that you generate and it has the inverse CDF with u plugged into it, that will generate a random variable x with a new distribution that you desired, which is f. Because you have to get the inverse CDF as part of this process, sometimes when you take the inverse of a CDF, there's not one unique inverse. So sometimes you also have to have this additional definition, which is that F inverse is equal to the infimum X, such that F of X is greater than or equal to U. So if you have more than one possible solution for the inverse, this can help you get a unique solution and still calculate the CDF or the inverse CDF using this technique. For this particular problem, I don't have this problem, so I don't have to use this additional technique for the example here. So I'm going to go ahead and get started with this example. For this example, I basically want to use the inverse transform method to create a random variable x that has this PDF distribution. And I'm telling you, if you can't recognize this, that this is going to be the exponential distribution. So I want to be able to generate a random variable x that's distributed exponential with the parameter lambda. This is the PDF for this distribution. So let's go ahead and go over how we do that using the inverse transform method. First, this is the PDF of the exponential distribution. So if you're given the PDF, the first thing you have to do is find the CDF, or the cumulative distribution function. So that's just going to be the integral from 0, which is the beginning existence of x here, 0 to x. And I'm just going to plug in the PDF, which is lambda e to the negative lambda x dx, and solve for this integral. So I'm going to use u substitution and say u is negative lambda x, then du is equal to negative lambda. I have lambda here already, so I just have to plug in negative 1. So I have negative 1 times lambda e to the u, and then this is basically du. So the integral of that is going to be negative e to the negative lambda x from 0 to x. When I plug in x and 0, that's going to give me negative times e to the negative lambda x minus e to the 0. E to the 0 is 1, so that's going to be 1 minus e to the negative lambda x. So the CDF for this PDF is going to be capital F of x is equal to 1 minus e to the negative lambda x for x is greater than or equal to 0. And it's going to be 0 for x is less than 0. And this is the CDF of the exponential distribution. Once we have the CDF that we want, that's going to be our f. And then the next thing we have to do is find the inverse CDF. So f inverse is what we're going to try to find next. So for step 2, I'm just going to say that f of x is equal to y, and y is equal to 1 minus e to the negative lambda x. And then to solve for the inverse, this is just like an algebra problem, so I'm basically going to solve for x. To do that, I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides. Then multiply by negative 1, so that's 1 minus y is equal to e to the negative lambda x. I'm going to take the natural log of both sides. That gives me negative lambda x on the right-hand side. And then I'm going to do multiply by negative 1 on both sides and divide by lambda on both sides. So that gives me that x is equal to negative log 1 minus y divided by lambda. So this would be f inverse y is equal to negative ln 1 minus y over lambda. The third and final step, which is very straightforward, is we just have to plug in the random variable u into that function. So the third and final step is that x is going to be equal to f inverse u. So this would be negative ln 1 minus u over lambda, where u is a uniformly distributed random variable from 0, 1 inclusive. So this is basically our final solution, and if we sample from a random variable with this distribution, we will get x that's exponentially distributed with parameter lambda. So I'm going to now switch over to the R demo, and I'm going to generate 1,000 random samples, or really pseudo-random samples, that are exponential lambda, and for this demo, I'm going to say lambda is equal to 3. Okay, so I switched over to R, and I'm just going to run this short little demo to show how you can randomly sample from a non-uniform distribution using the inverse transform method, and it's a very short line of code. If anyone wants to replicate this, I'm just going to set the seed to 1337 just to make sure I get the same numbers over and over again. And I'm going to try to randomly sample 1,000 samples. So I'm going to try to generate 1,000 samples in this demo. So the first thing is I'm going to randomly sample from u, the uniformly distributed random variable. So I'm going to get 1,000 random samples from the uniform 0, 1 distribution, and I'm setting that to a vector variable a. So now if I choose to view a or print a, it's going to give me 1,000 samples that are between the values 0 and 1, approximately uniformly distributed because it's randomly sampled. So in the next line of code, I'm going to plot a histogram of the vector a, and that should give me roughly a uniform distribution. So you can see all the different values that a is taking on in the vector, and these are roughly uniformly distributed across all the possible values 0 and 1. So we do have a uniform random variable in A. Then in the next part, B is going to be the new F inverse distribution that we created. So we said that that was negative the natural log 1 minus u, in which case u is A here, divided by 3. That's the parameter lambda that I'm setting equal to 3. I'm going to run that. That will give me 1,000 random samples from the new distribution. And we're saying that using this inverse transform method, that new distribution is exponential with lambda is equal to 3. If I print B, this gives me all the new values of the random sample. So now we have 1,000 new random samples that are not uniformly distributed. And again, to prove that it kind of looks roughly exponentially distributed, I'm going to plot the histogram of all the values B. And now when I plot this, we see that we went from a roughly uniform distributed sample to a roughly exponentially distributed random variable B. So it looks like the inverse transform method works, at least empirically it seems to work, and we can say that we have 1,000 samples that are distributed exponential with lambda equal to 3. And that's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.